What is up, YouTubians? Kudumalo here, coming at you with another exciting review. All right, so please keep in mind that this video is for entertainment purposes only. This is basically my review of the Rescue Me car escape tool. So if you want the short and sweet version, keep in mind, entertainment purposes only. If you want the short and sweet version, basically, if I was stuck in a vehicle where I absolutely had to get out, like the car's on fire, the car's sinking into a lake or something, the way I would use this thing is basically pull the tool itself from the blade guard, try to cut through the seatbelt, and then use the window punch to press against the glass, break the glass, and then get out of the vehicle. If you want to stick around, I'll share with you some of my thought process, how I arrived at that determination with the tool. So let's go over some of the features, what the tool's all about, all that good stuff, what comes in the box, and et cetera. So this is the box that you get when you order the tool. It says when seconds count. And in some situations, they're not kidding because seconds may actually matter. So it has that on both sides of the box. Here's the box, the box, the box. This is a two-pack, which is kind of cool. The options for this tool, there's a link in the description below that I put down there. There are, or there were at least 11 different colors to choose from. So there's, for example, there's red, orange, there's a pink color, there's black, there's a neon, there's a green, there's a blue. List goes on and on for 11 different color options. Then I had the choice of choosing whether to buy quantity of one, quantity of two, or quantity of three. So I went with the two-pack, or the Tupac, pun intended, because I wanted to have one of them to attach to my vehicle. And what Rescue Me is saying in the instructions, I'll show this to you in a second, what Rescue Me is saying is to attach it to the rearview mirror. That way I would always know where it is. You know, if the car flipped over or whatever, it was there. And then I got a second one. The reason why I got the Tupac was because I got a second one just to have on my person at all times if I'm traveling. So if I'm in somebody else's vehicle, if I'm on like public transportation, the bus, you know, you get the idea, rail system, whatever it is. But also sometimes for work, we get driven to places, like we park at one spot or show up at one spot and then our employer will drive us to another location. So it's something I would have with me, whether it's in a first aid kit, trauma kit, you know, you get the idea. So anyways, the box is like this. Because I got the two-pack, what came in the box was the tool itself. There's a blade guard. There's a key ring right there. And then there's a zip tie. And if you're curious about the measurements, the tool itself is about 2.5 inches. With the blade guard, it comes out to about 3 inches. And then with the key ring and the zip tie, you know, you're looking at anywhere from like 5 to 6 inches, depending on how you cinch the zip tie down. What you also get is the instructions. The instructions are kind of cool because they do have illustrations of, you know, what everything is. So like an illustration, for example, would show you like, this is the tool. C would be the window punch. B would be the blade cut. A is the blade guard, which is right there. You get the ring and then you get the zip tie. And then it's showing you like A, you know, detach the tool from the blade guard. B, cut the seatbelt if you had to. And then C would be use your window punch, you know, press against the window. They're showing you to use the corner of the window to punch through the window for maximum effect. All right, so thought process. So let me give you some scenarios, things that I've encountered personally where a person could use one of these. You know, let's say I'm in a car and it's flood season. You know, thunderstorm comes out of nowhere. I'm driving through what I think is a shallow creek, and all of a sudden the car gets surrounded by, you know, a 3-foot wall of water, 4-foot wall of water. I need to get out of that car. So let's say I've lost power. So I try for the door handles not working. You know, most cars nowadays have electronically controlled windows, power windows. Pushing that button, the window's not rolling down. I need to get out of that car. Or maybe I'm in a situation where I got into a car accident. Car erupts into flames, like the whole front engine compartment of the car is on fire, loss of power, can't open the door, can't roll down the window, I need to get out of the car. Let's say third scenario, let's say I'm in a situation where, you know, I'm driving down a freeway or a road, it's fire season, and there's a whole bunch of cars that are stopped up ahead of me, and traffic comes to a complete stop, And now I realize if I look to the passenger side, there's a 50-foot wall of fire there that's about ready to engulf the entire car, and I need to get out of the car. And all of a sudden, for whatever reason, there's no power to the car anymore. Can't roll down the window, can't open the door. You get the idea. So the features of the tool itself are that you do have a blade color cutter to cut through your seatbelt, and you also have a window punch to break a window if you had to do that. So the question is, if I was in a car accident, the first question is am I okay? You know, I'm going to check myself first. You know, can I wiggle my fingers and toes? Do I feel like I have a broken bone, broken leg, spinal injury, whatever? Do that first, you know, and kind of determine, like, do I need to get out of this car? So the second question I would ask myself is, what's my environment like? What's going on around my car? Do I smell smoke? Do I smell any kind of like burning plastic or anything? Do I smell gasoline fumes? You know, your car might not be gas powered. It might be electric powered, like Tesla. There were a couple of Teslas in the news recently where the batteries malfunctioned, the whole front engine compartment burst into flames. You know, so that would be a situation I would think about is, is there an immediate danger that I need to exit the vehicle, or am I fine just sitting where I am in the vehicle? A lot of times people don't think about that. You know, if I'm in an accident, I may have hurt my spine, my back, my neck. You know, I just want to make sure that me leaving the car is not going to cause more damage to myself, you know, that it is okay to leave the car. So then after I've assessed myself and the environment, now what I want to do is, you know, make sure everything's okay. So let me try the seatbelt. I'm pulling on the seatbelt. Seatbelt won't unlatch. You know, sometimes worst case scenario, or one of the worst case scenarios, is the car landed on its side, or the car flipped upside down, is on the roof. The weight of my body pushing against the seatbelt may cause it to bind up, and I might not be able to release the seatbelt. So that would be a problem that now I need to solve. So solving the problem, what do? I reach for my escape tool, which according to Rescue Me is best to keep near or on the attached to the rearview mirror. That's why they give you the zip tie. So the way that process works is when you get the tool, basically you attach the blade protector is going to be on the tool itself, but you attach the ring on, attach the zip tie. Zip tie, let's use this as an example. Zip tie goes around the rearview mirror, zip tie that down. Now you know where it is, or now I know where it is when I need to use it. So like I said, in the situation, the car's on its side upside down, or for whatever reason, I can't pull on the seatbelt, I'm going to pull the tool from the blade guard. It does take a little bit of force to pull this out. I'm going to use the tool to cut the seatbelt. So just as an example, this is just a piece of an envelope, piece of plastic, plastic bag. I know it's not a seatbelt, but just to show you that it will work, is basically you loop this underneath. See if I can get this the right way. You loop this underneath your seatbelt and then pull, and basically you slice through the seatbelt. Oh my God, it's magic. It just cut through. So now that I've cut through my seatbelt and I'm able to move about the cabin, pun intended, now what I want to do is I want to take a further assessment of the environment. So I'm going to look first, you know, can I get out the driver's door, because that is the closest to me. But is it the safest option? You know, if I look out that door and there's a cliff over here, obviously I'm not going to go out that door, right? So now I'm going to go to this door, look at the driver's or the passenger door, you know, and assess the situation. Is it free to go out that door? Am I going to hit any obstruction? Remember the situation about the engine compartment being on fire, which is common, believe it or not, in most car accidents, or a lot of car accidents, you know, something of any severity. There could be flames coming down the sides of the vehicle. What if there's a wind blowing this way, or if the wind is blowing this way? So I might not want to go out either the driver's door or the passenger door. So let me check a rear door. One tip or trick that I like to do is I always keep either a towel with me, whether it's in the first aid kit or whether it's just on me or in my backpack or whatever, or I keep paper towels in the sides of the door, you know, where the pockets are, or sometimes in the center console. So if I have paper towels with me, what I'll do is I'll get those ready before I break the window. So the problem is the door handles aren't working. I need to punch through the glass to get out. And the reason for the paper towels and the towel is because when I push this thing against the window, it's spring loaded, and there's a little spike in there. which is what actually breaks the window. So as I push, push, push against the window, all the glass is going to come down, right? If I have tinted windows or if I'm in a vehicle with laminated windows of some kind, I just want to make sure that I put the towel to protect myself, right? So I might have the tool in hand and then put the towel over my hand basically. So now basically my hand is protected as I punch through, there it is, as I punch through the window, right? So at least my hand is now protected. The other thing I can use the towel for is to lay over the door, right? So that now when I'm exiting the vehicle, I'm not going to be putting my hand down on just straight up glass or broken glass. So now I can actually, basically get out of the vehicle and at least have some protection. You know, tetanus shot, that's the last thing I want to do. Another reason, this has happened a few times on the scenes of an accident that I've come across. Somebody gets attacked by an inflatable doll. I'm not judging. I'm just saying it happens. So if you have to use this tool to cut through an inflatable doll, I'm joking, but you get the idea. No inflatable dolls were harmed or injured during the making of this video. But if you have to cut through something other than your seatbelt to get out the door, just know that that's another thing that you could use a razor blade for. So anyways, a further step in the process, you know, before you get out of the vehicle is a lot of times you get Good Samaritans, Ricky Rescues, you know, you name it. Ask them to help you. You know, what's the situation like? Hey, I'm inside the car. You're outside the car. What do you see around my vehicle? Is it safe to go out here? Traffic is one of the worst things. You just got into an accident and there's some knucklehead that's speeding past you going 60, 80 miles an hour because they're in a rush to get to wherever they got to go to. So ask the person helping you, you know, hey, do you mind going over to the safer side of the car? Check the car. Is it easier, safer to go out the passenger side? Because there is no traffic here. There's no cliff to fall off of. There's nothing. There's no fire on this side. You know, what's the safest way to get out of the car? Let them help you. You know, ask them, are they a rescue worker? Call 911. Be on the phone with the operator. You know, the operator will run through a checklist of things to help assess your situation. You know, the operator will ask you, are you in any imminent danger? Is there a fire? Do you smell smoke? You know, all that kind of stuff. The operator may also ask you, is there anybody on scene that can help you to get out of the car? Because even though you may not be able to get out the door, like let's say there was a fire, engine compartment fire, and the fire's blasting the side of the door. Another reason for this towel is to assess the situation. You know, grab the door handle with the towel so you don't burn your hand. You know, or ask somebody outside the car, hey, do you see smoke or fire coming towards the front? Is it safer for me to exit through a rear door? Is traffic moving in this direction? Should I exit on this side of the car? You know, whatever, flip-flop, whatever the situation is, you know, always try to be a king or queen of communication. You know, try to talk to whoever can help you. Try to delegate. You know, hey, is my car teetering on the edge of a cliff? Is it better for me to stay put because the weight of my body is keeping the car in place? You know, have somebody help you out. And use that, it's there if they are willing to help you. Good Samaritan, Ricky Rescue, you know, have them help you out. So anyways, there is a link in the description below, 11 different colors to choose from. You can buy these in 1, 2, or 3 packs, as stated below. No inflatable dolls were injured during the course of making this video. I'm Cooter Malloy. There is a like button down there. There's a subscribe button down there. Go ahead and hit both of those if you like what you're seeing. Go ahead and comment below if you have any comments. But there are some illustrations here. The directions are in English. They're in Spanish. They are in French. They are in German, Italian, and I believe Dutch, right? NL, Netherlands, Dutch. So anyways, comment down below. Let me know if you have any other ideas for videos, etc. I'm Cooter Malloy, and I will catch you guys on the next one.